really good.
That's okay. That's okay. They lost time on leg number three. It was always a possibility. And Ericsson just unable to stay with the pace of the leaders. Norway, France, Russia, still the leading three. Welcome back. We're approaching crunch time in the men's 4x7.5 relay. The third leg runners are on the way to the exchange, and then it's down to the anchor men to see what they can do. And Martin Fourcade is ready to go for the French, and he has one hungry Norwegian to catch. That is going to be a great battle because Emil Hegle Svendsen and Martin Fourcade are the two contending the top position. They're certainly the two favourites for the overall World Cup this year. And incidentally, Michael sending us an email saying that he fancies Svendsen and Domrasheva for the individual overall World Cups this year. I think it's a difficult season to call. If anyone can beat Fourcade, I'm not sure it's going to be Svendsen.
Svendsen, he got there as soon as he has a bad race. He was 33rd in the sprint race, moved right up to what was 15th, 16th yesterday, 12th in fact. And the fastest ski time, he is so good. Mentally, for me, Svendsen is one of the best ever. Has a bad day, he'll turn it around the next day. But I agree, Fourcade is a difficult man to beat. He's one of the best. He's up there with Bjørn Dalen in terms of how good he is.
Well, I'm going to put my money early season to be doing it, but on Birnbacher, because I think his withdrawal from the relay today is a clear sign that his focus is the overall World Cup.
Interesting, and Birnbacher, he's so safe on the range. He's one of the fastest shots in the world regularly.
Yeah, but it's going to be tough to beat Fourcade. He's so strong. But for the first time yesterday, we saw that there are athletes here who can outski the Frenchman on the final lap, should it come to a sprint. Uwe Mossigang in the background in the men's relay, a man who was responsible for the success of the German women's team for many, many years. So the margin, Mike, last time we saw when they came out of the range, we had France 30.9 behind, and now they find themselves 42 behind. In terms of shots missed on the range, what do you think that relates to?
Well, 42, you've got certainly three spare rounds.
And half a penalty loop.
But when you're looking at this man, at Svendsen, going last for the Norwegians, really, with three spare rounds, he's so confident as Svendsen, and the ski pace that he's showing now is quite phenomenal. He's nearly missing his start. Why would you be late to a start?
Yeah, I think there'll be a little bit of a ticking off for Svendsen. That's a little bit casual, considering the good work that Christiansen has just done. And credit to the youngsters in the Norwegian team. Birkeland, an excellent first leg. Christiansen, an astonishing third leg to open up this margin ahead of France. Great battle going on for third, fourth and fifth. The Russians in third. Graf of Germany just being overtaken by Pinter on the approach to the exchange. In fact, was that Austria that Pinter was just blasting past? 30.9 seconds, and the margin growing over the last kilometer as well. 47 now. Russia just 3 seconds behind France. Those two maybe can work together.
Malishko just took off like lightning. He wants to go in the slipstream of Martin Fourcade. Will it be possible, and will it do more damage to try and stay with Fourcade?
Malishko, a really good race yesterday, worked his way up into second position, outsprinted Martin Fourcade as well in that pursuit. So away go Germany, and it is no one other than Arndt Peiffer on the last leg. No Birnbacher, remember, he's decided to rest after two very good days of individual competition. Birnbacher first and fifth. He faded a little at the end of the pursuit, but winning that sprint, his first victory of the season. Austria, fifth position from 17th, a gain of 12 in the last two legs. If they can keep that going, they'll certainly be looking for a top three. And the Czech Republic aren't out of it quite yet. Sixth position at the moment, and a margin, as you can see there, of 137. Best shooting still the Norwegians. We'll be right back. Norway out on their own here in Austria. Whoops, a little unsteady. In fact, this looks like Christiansen, and it's certainly not Emil Hegler Svensson. Now, I wonder whether the... we certainly haven't heard anything. It's Lave Lund, Henrik Lave Lund, who's come in to take the last leg for Norway. I think maybe, Mike, the reason he wasn't ready is it could well have been a last-minute decision from Svensson. Is that possible? When do you have to make your changes in the team?
Normally, if it's a medical, you've got to give at least 1 hour's notice if there's ill health, stomach bug, sickness. So this must have clearly, at the beginning of the day, they must have put this down as a change. But Lave Lund was so unprepared. He was still putting his ski poles on after the exchange. So he really doesn't look like he's at the races yet, but he's still leading.
Well, I wonder whether he didn't want to make an appearance on the track so France weren't aware that it wasn't Svensson in front, because if you told Fourcade that he only had 40 seconds to gain on Lave Lund, he'd fancy his chances, whereas he wouldn't have fancied his chances of catching Svensson.
It's interesting, the change. Well, there's no real gain from France. In fact, 40 seconds behind at the exchange. 47, yeah, 7 seconds already. Martin Fourcade has pulled back. So the coach is in the sunshine on this hill. It's a good hill to pass on the information. And so important in the relay to get split timings off the athlete ahead of you. Pfeiffer, I was surprised at Pfeiffer yesterday. He didn't show us his best form at all. He was looking good in Östersund last weekend. Pfeiffer, a 40th position in the sprint race, and he moved up to 25th position, missing 3 targets. Now, Landetinger, there he is, just going under the road. He shoots very fast. He will need to try and close this gap for Austria.
Here comes Fourcade. He's looking nice and light on his feet. That characteristic dance up the hill, which was really introduced by Raphael Poiret in his heyday back in 2003-2004.
Talking of Raphael Poiret, his teammate, the Belarus team, they're shooting so well. They've only... I make them equal second best shooting team, but they're down in 13th position, 3:22 off the pace. It's not too bad, and I think they'll get better as the season goes on with all the changes he's made to their technique, to their training methods. It takes some time for the change to happen.
Well, they're in no danger of being lapped and taken out of this race. Teams that I think we've lost, Romania have gone, Great Britain I think have been lapped now, Lithuania, Poland, Japan we saw getting lapped earlier on, so they are out. We're left with 19 teams, and the USA are some 4 minutes 31 behind. Each lap is taking around 5.5-6 minutes, so the USA need to just sharpen up their game a little as we watch Lave Lund first shoot. He looks a little bit nervous, Mike, but you can understand that.
Last leg in the relay is the pressure leg.
Clear before Fourcade takes his place in the range. He can. Good shooting. First time of asking. They all go down, and Norway now still have only required one spare round. That's something that will certainly keep the coaching team happy, but they know that Martin Fourcade is dangerous. Now, Michael, who sent us an email telling us Svensson was going to win the overall World Cup, also commenting on the loading of the magazine on Fourcade's rifle. It is a vertical load, Mike. It's the spare rounds that he was at one stage keeping horizontal.
Well, that's right. You can see the line of spare bullets, all 6 of them, just in front of his trigger finger. And that's the change he's made. He's felt it's quicker to pull them out of the side of the rifle rather than straight up and down.
Well, with that miss, the margin could go back to its original 40 seconds. Well, in fact, it was 47 seconds at the exchange. So I think we're going to be similar position to where we started. But instead of 7.5 kilometres to make up the time, Fourcade now just has 5 kilometres. Russia clear and hold on to third place. Arndt Pfeiffer now for Germany. The Austrians would love to beat the Germans here on their own snow. It's a possibility. It's a distinct possibility, but Landertinger.
I think he had to go for the high risk. He had to push himself out on the track to try and get Austria back into the podium area.
Well, they're involved in a little duel. It's the Czech Republic with Vitek who are going to come through and claim fourth position. And a penalty loop for Germany, and Arndt Peiffer, and that is a huge disappointment to the travelling crowd. And there are thousands of Germans who've made the journey here to Hochfilzen to see a good performance. They might have to wait for this afternoon to see if they get a victory.
Well, Arndt Peiffer's had so many good days in World Cup racing, but that surely has to be one of his worst. Germany up there in, what, fourth position? And now they're going to drop down to, what, seventh, maybe eighth position.
Good shooting from Mariasko of Slovakia. They'll move up ahead of Germany. Only a few seconds, but they will be ahead of them going into the last two loops. Ukraine, nice and solid. Their skiing's not up to it, but Sednev, absolute hot shot with the rifle. And he clears the five for as good a shoot as we've seen all day. Sweden with Bergman, a change of the sights.
It's two clicks to the right. Therefore, he's feeling the wind is from the left.
Norway also changing the sights.
So the wind has just started to influence the very, very slightly. And maybe that's what got Peiffer out. There's a shimmy here, even in minus 15, you get from the snow, some currents coming up.
Lukas Hoffer. 15 to 20 seconds given away with those two misses, but not a bad performance from the Italians, but they're outside the top eight. Exceptional performances from the Czech Republic and Slovakia, but Norway still leading. So half the job is done for Henrik Lavelund. Now he has the hardest part of the course to cover before he comes in for his final shoot. Just behind him, it is the US, in fact, it's Britain now, who have been lapped by the Norwegians. And I don't think we're going to see them again out on the tracks once they come into the stadium.
Well, that's Pete Beyer out there. Again, like Kevin Kane, brought in from the IBU Cup, performing well there. The IBU Cup, Patrick, with Eberhardt there winning the 10 kilometres. Setting some of the fastest ski times here. Ruben, delighted.
Now, will Norway keep their record? This would be the best relay performance for some time if Lavelund can clear five with five in the stand. Have you ever seen, I can't remember a team that's hit every single shot, 48.